Hi, my name's Gary Maclean and I'm executive chef at the City of Glasgow College, and I'm also Scotland's first national chef. And at this time of year, I'm normally in New York enjoying your hospitality, your food, your culture, and celebrating all things Scottish. But this year is completely different, as we all know. And what I thought I would do was share a little bit of where I come from to you. And not only am I going to share the area, but I'm also going to share the food. Right at this moment, I'm in a place called Wallace Well, and it's about 100 yards from my front door. And this is the place where William Wallace took his last drink as a free man. He was en route to meet the Bishop of Glasgow to ask for his support in Scottish independence. He often came here for a drink in his travels. Just further down the road is the Wallace Memorial, and it's where William Wallace actually got captured. And that's going to be our next stop, and I'm going to show you some amazing food from that location as well. We've moved a couple of hundred yards along the road from Wallace's Well to the Wallace Memorial. And this memorial marks the site of Wallace's betrayal. There was a tavern here, and Sir John Menteith, a Scottish knight who was loyal to Edward, betrayed William Wallace, and he upturned a table in the tavern to indicate to the English that Wallace was here. So what I want to do is I want to cook some food that I think would have been served in the tavern. We're North Glasgow, and we have an abundance of roe deer, and I want to show you some beautiful Scottish roe deer. I'm going to cook it right here on this site where William Wallace was captured. So welcome to my kitchen. It's not often I get to cook on location, a couple of hundred yards from the house. All my neighbours are looking out the windows thinking I'm bonkers, and I'm hoping the police don't come. But here we are. So the hero of the reason I'm doing this demo today is to showcase this incredible venison, which is absolutely everywhere around where I live. So we've got this amazing venison that is found everywhere around here. If we're lucky, you might actually catch one in the camera. So beautiful venison, really lean, really healthy, and Scotland's amazing at producing and getting that to market. I'm also going to use some fantastic Scottish rapeseed oil, and I'm going to add some seaweed. I've got a little seaweed, which is, I'm going to use as a seasoning. You know, it's going to give loads of umami flavour. I've also made a little oatmeal granola. So great Scottish oatmeal, Scottish honey, some shallots and some hazelnuts in there. Texture. And in this little tray of goodies here, I've got some goose fat potatoes, some caramelized cauliflower, some candied shallots, and I've got some brambles, which I'm going to put through the dish as well, which again will just give you a little cut of sharpness. So without further ado, let's get our venison working. So we've got a nice hot pan, get that beautiful rapeseed oil in. And the joys of cooking outside is the temperature of pans, and we've got a really nice sizzle. So we're looking for loads of caramelization, loads of colour, loads of heat. We pop in some hard herbs and just that little bit extra flavour. And we just really want to roast this in the pan, get loads of colour, loads of flavour created. So, got loads of colour on the venison. So loads of residual flavour in the bottom of the pan as well. And at this stage here, I'm going to pop in my little goose fat potatoes, cauliflower and shallots. And all I want to do here really is just warm this back through and just make sure I lift all those flavours from the bottom of the pan. And to do that, I'm going to add a good knob of butter, and on top of that I'm going to put a little pan, and what that's going to do is going to create a kind of little oven, and that'll warm everything back through, and it'll also make sure that the venison is cooked. So we want the venison to be nice and pink. We don't want it too pink, and we don't want it overcooked. That'll just take a little minute or two. We've still got our oatmeal granola, our seaweeds as well. We pop in some chives, and then the blackberries I'm going to put in right at the end. So we've given that a few minutes, and you can tell just by touching the top of the pan how much heat you've got in there. And what we've done is created like a little bit of an oven. I'm just going to remove that pan. And as you can see, it's absolutely stunning. Saw that lovely flavour from the venison. Next thing is I'm going to remove the venison from the pan and just allow that to rest. And that gives me a chance to pop in these amazing brambles. And we're just going to warm them through. To that, I'm going to add some of this stunning Mara seaweed. And it works if you can get your head around the fact that it's seaweed, but it's seasoning. It's really natural. And it works really, really well with this dish. We're going to go for plate up. So we're going to take our beautiful little goose fat potatoes, our little caramelized shallots. Again, loads of big flavors here. Really, really works well with the venison. Get our cauliflower on there. And you can see those brambles have just started to bleed a little bit, which is gorgeous. So the next thing I want to do is to take some of the venison and we're just going to carve and pop that onto the plate. We've got our little oatmeal granola. And then I'm just going to, it's almost like a little dressing, just get those beautiful brambles onto the plate. Again, I'm going to give a little spark, all that beautiful flavour. And then to finish, I've just got a little bit of our chopped chives. So that is a beautiful local venison cooked at the Wallace Memorial, where I come from. I hope you've enjoyed this, and I'd just like to thank my daughter for filming and editing, producing, and generally bossing me around while doing it. So hopefully see you all soon. Bye bye.